What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about users inside of Pterodactyl. Now, chances are, if you're here, you've already gone to the users tab inside of your server, added a user, and it doesn't work. Well, this is exactly how you get around that. So it's going to allow you to give someone access to your game server instance. They'll be able to start, restart, pretty much do whatever you want them to do. So first thing to do if you're at your Pterodactyl dashboard is to click on settings in the top right hand corner. Then we're going to go down to users on the left hand side, and then we need to create a new user. So this is where we're going to put in their email address. So let's go big Pedro at pedro.com. Add a username, Pedro2. Actually, let's call it Pedro. Client first name, Pedrotsky. And then over here, it says administrator. We're going to leave that as no, unless you want to give them access to everything on the back end. Just leave administrator blank. And then for the password, we're just going to call it Pedro as well. So then we click on create user. All right, so now we've got a new user called Pedrotsky. And then all we need to do is go back to the dashboard. And then let's say I want to give someone access to Quake Live. So we go click on Quake Live, our server instance, and then we click on users. And then we need to put in their email address, which I've already forgotten. Let me just grab it again. It's big Pedro at pedro.com. And then we just need to, let's just set up something under control. So let's go start, stop, and restart. Now there is a button up here that says invite user, but that's not going to work unless you've set up SMTP, which is the mailing protocol. So we need to go down at the bottom, click invite user, sorry, but it's not going to send them an email to invite them to use the panel. Alright, so now that's done, we can just log into the panel. So I'm going to log in on this screen here. Let's go big Pedro at pedro.com. My password, which is Pedro, if you want to hack it. Oops. Okay, what have I forgotten? Aha, bye Pedro, I'm bye now, so bye Pedro at pedro.com. All right, so then as we go into the server instance here, and you see there's no console or anything. So we got the administrator on the left here. We don't see any console. It's just literally restart, stop. So we can stop the server, then we can start the server. We don't get access to anything. We can't type anything into the console here. Don't have access to any of the file manager you see up top. So let's say we want to give this user access to, let's modify some files. So we can go down here to file. We can just click this box here. It's going to give them access for everything. And then I'm pretty sure if we just we have to save it. So we've saved it, and then if I refresh our freshly made account here, it says here file manager, and then we can access files in here. So I can go and delete these files if I want. There we go, deleted, probably broke the server. But that's pretty much that simple. So the main ones, you're going to give one of your friends, you're going to give them access to everything under control here, so they can, not friends, but people who are going to access the server. The main one is going to be control, and then just start, stop, restart. In case the server crashes, they can quickly log in and turn it back on. Or file. The rest of the stuff, you pretty much don't need to give them access to any of it. Maybe schedule if they're going to set up a schedule, but for the most part, you're going to be just giving them access to everything under file and then everything under control. That way they've got access to modify files, restart the server, stop the server, etc. So it's pretty simple, but yeah, the main thing you have to do, have to add them in this backend, add them in the backend here, and then give them access to the instance, not just giving them access to the server instance. So I hope that clears up any confusion that you had. If you still get stuck, come and join us on Discord. We've got a tech support channel where we can help you out and all that jazz. And yeah, if this video helped, leave a comment, leave a like, it'll really help me out, or even subscribe. And I hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.